Jesus was indeed born the King of Israel in Bethlehem of Judea long ago. But he wasn't born just for that time or for that place. He was the King of Kings for all time, for all people, for all eternity. In today's world, the idea of a king, of an absolute monarch, is almost impossible to imagine. We are a people who want to self-govern, to be independent of all rulers. We resist the idea of submitting to any one leader. But this king, this Jesus, was sent from heaven. He was God's son. He would be the ultimate, the perfect sovereign, the only one to whom we can completely trust our lives.
Born on Christmas Day to save.
God's people had waited for a long time for an earthly king to reign over them, one who would lead them, one who would love them, one who would deliver them. And then, when the time was right, God sent an angel to a young girl. He told her, "You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. He will reign forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary was quite confused. She was a virgin and not of royal birth, just a peasant girl. But the angel convinced her that she had been chosen for this marvelous miracle, that she was the one who would give birth to this king, the Savior of the world. And this was really good news. Were ecstatic that the eternal king was born. They wanted to announce his birth to the whole world. However, the father had another plan. He chose the lowest of the low, a group of homeless men, shepherds, living out in the fields, to be the first to receive the word. And they would be the first to be granted an audience with the newborn king. But they found that the king's palace was a stable. His cradle was a feeding trough. Nothing regal, nothing majestic, nothing kingly about him or his surroundings. How could this be? How could someone so humble, so ordinary, rule over all people for all time? Even the angels did not know how this would be, but they bowed to the Father anyway. Knowing that he was in control, their response was total praise.
Angels from the realms of glory, we
Come and see what God has done. That's what the Magi from the Far East were doing when they traveled for many months, following a star that led them to Bethlehem. They were looking for the King, a heavenly King, born in human flesh. And when they finally saw him, they knew their journey had not been in vain. Their immediate response was to fall on their knees.
Long lay the world in sin and death.
The king was born. He lived and died and rose again, and then ascended back into heaven. He is here now in spirit. His eternal kingdom is among us. It is Jesus who rules in the hearts of those who will allow him in. But those who are accepted into the kingdom must enter as little children, humble and surrendered and needy. Come and see what God has done. Come and let the peace of Christ rule your heart and know the joy of his everlasting love.
Shine.